2 Timothy 4 and 10. Matthew 24 and 12 says, and because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. And because iniquity or sin does so much abound, the love of many shall wax cold. All right. 2 Timothy 4, verse 10. For Demas has forsaken me, having loved this present world, and is departed unto Thessalonica. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Passing through the church.
Passing through the church.
You may be seated.
Amen, amen.
When you pick up the newspaper, you will read of late a producer, an executive, an actor has been charged or accused of some kind of abuse. When you pick up the paper or you turn on the television, to ABC, NBC, ESPN, CNN, you will see someone was shot to death. Someone was killed today. Mm-hmm. Someone was ran over today.
Right.
Someone was stabbed today. Mm-hmm. Someone was blown up today. Somebody was killed. And then when you read we're in a church, people were shot and killed. And these were people that were in the church to praise and worship their God. You might ask, if you can get shot and killed serving God, where can you go? Oh, and if I can be shot and killed while I'm serving God, why should I serve Him?
Wow, wow.
Where was God? You see, the Bible says, because iniquity does so much abound, the love of many is waxing cold. Because after the church shooting, there were things on the internet that said, where was God?
On hell.
Atheists were saying, you believed in God, but it didn't help you none. You said there was a God whose love, so I guess this was his sign to show you love. When you lose a child, and you lose a father or a mother. I called home April the 6th of 2006 and said, Mom, let me speak to my dad. She said, your dad is downstairs asleep. My dad was dead in the chair. And you asked, where was God? When friends are driving in a car that you know that love the Lord, and they get killed in the car accident, the devil says, where was your God?
Wow, wow.
Oh, the preacher's gonna say, well, you know, it was just God's will. Well, you know, things like that happen. Well, you know, you need to just pray. Well, you know, it's gonna be all right. It's not always gonna be all right.
Wow, wow.
Man.
It doesn't always turn to be out all right. And there's a lot of times when you ask God why, He doesn't answer. In fact, most of the time you ask God why, He doesn't answer. And because so much tragedy is going on day after day after day, people come to the point where they say, you know, I really don't feel like going to church today. I'm just really not feeling God. Because iniquity does so much abound, the love of many is starting to wax cold. It's getting harder for people to understand divorced. Where is my God when I need him? And because we really don't have an answer, the devil is quick to say he's not there.
Well.
That's why he didn't answer. Because he's really not there. Or he's there, but he really don't care. Yeah. He's really not as interested in you as you are in him. And when those things weigh in on us, we fade away from the church. We find ourselves going through the motions.
Right.
And we find ourselves passing through the church. We find ourselves passing through. Herein the scriptures, Paul had a companion by the name of Demas. Demas had walked with Paul for a period of time. But there came some incident that the Bible doesn't speak of, that Demas turned around and he no longer followed Paul. And he went back, it seems like, into the world.
Lord help.
What do you do when you get this kind of news? What do you do when folks that you walk with decide they can't walk this walk anymore? In Kansas, I had a friend that used to go to church with me all the time from another church. And when he come up, oh, he would shout, he would give God praise. He's about this tall, real stocky dude. And I had moved away and I got a call from the pastor, and the pastor said, "Brother Green, did you hear?" I said, "Did I hear what?" He said, "So-and-so got killed." I said, "How did he get killed?" He said that he went on top of the highway drunk and he got hit by a semi truck. And I'm thinking, what was he doing drinking? He's a Christian. He's in the church. What did he go get drunk for? And he said, because he walked away from the church and he went back to the lifestyle that he used to know. Passing through the church. You see, there are times when our pain becomes so great that the hospital is no longer able, we think, to handle our pain, so we check our own selves out. Have you ever been in the hospital and they want you to stay and you decided, yeah, I'm leaving? Yeah. Or you get there and they tell you, well, you really need to check in, and you say, I'm gonna be all right. You try to do your self-medication or your...
Pointing fingers.
Amen. I remember feeling like my heart was going bad and got in the wheelchair and went up there. They had me in the wheelchair and wanted to check me in. I said, how long? Oh, come on. Oh, no, I gotta go. But it seems like when we face these things, we just get up and we walk away.
Yeah.
Man.
Don't pass through the church on your way to hell. There are a lot of folks that are stopping by the church to get their pain eased. There are a lot of folks stopping by the church to hear some good news. But because sin is so strong, they keep on passing by.
Yeah.
Don't pass through the church. Become the church.
Yeah.
Don't pass through the church. Don't pass through the doors on your way to hell. Don't make church a sideline. Make church a lifeline.
Amen.
Don't make church a rest stop. Make church the pit stop to get what you need, that you can continue to go on with God. Don't just pass through the church.
Amen.
Oh, there are folks that come in that are hurting.
Because God always doesn't fix it now. They walk away from the church saying, I just couldn't find what I needed. I just couldn't find happiness. Mm-hmm. Well, honey, you don't need to look for happiness. You need to find joy.
Amen.
Oh, yeah.
You need to find peace.
Yes, yes, yes.
Only found through the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Oh, demons has forsaken me. Having a love for this present world. Don't you know, church, that the love of this world is to be an enemy with God? Love not the world, nor the things that are in the world.
Yes.
For all that is in the world is lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. Yes. Oh, don't fall in love with the world, because the world will pull on you, honey.
Yes.
The world will pull you from the church. The world will pull you out of church. Oh, y'all remember, y'all too young to remember the Call of the Wild, not about a dog that was raised by wolves. And it thought, and when it came back home one night, it heard that, oh. It didn't do that, but and it got up and it tried to run with the pack and they wore him out. Don't you know the devil doesn't care about you? The devil don't like you. In fact, because you were in the church, he hates you. And when he pulls you from the church, he'll kill you. He'll try to take your life and he'll make it as if God didn't care. Mm-hmm. Passing through the church, yeah, on our way to hell. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, church, when we come into God's house, you will only get from the church what you put into the church.
Amen.
Oh, somebody will say, how was church today? And you say, you know, it just wasn't that exciting.
Wow.
How was church today? Well, the church didn't have that today. How was church today? Well, it really didn't move me. Well, if the church don't move you, if God don't move you, you do something to move God.
Yeah.
You do something to get God to move. You do something to get God's attention, and you do that through praise. You do that through worship. You do that through thanking Jesus. Been traveling, and people say, are you here to stay? And you said, no, I'm just passing through. I'm passing through. I'm not here to stay. I'm just passing through. You can't just pass through the church and make it to heaven, y'all. You can't just come in when you decide to come in and leave when you decide to leave. You got to be in this thing to the end.
Yes, yes.
Oh, you can't serve God on a part-time basis. Right. As Brother Harold said, you can't be a part-time Christian trying to defeat a full-time devil.
Amen. Amen.
It just won't work.
That's right.
You'll get defeated every time. But when you come into the church, you got to come in to stay. There was a newspaper writer, a young dude trying to win to be a great writer, and he was waiting on a good story to come. And finally, a storm came, and the dam up broke, and it flooded one of the little towns. And so he said, I can get me a story there. And so as he began to go, he saw a woman on top of a house. And he saw the stove going down the street. He said, well, that's a story. She said, nah. And he saw a cow floating by. Nah, that's not a good story. And in the meantime, he saw this hat go down. And then the hat came back up. Then the hat will go down. And he said, I'm gonna write about that. That's a story. And that woman said, no, it ain't. That's just my husband. He He's cutting the grass. He said, come hell or high water, I'm going to cut it. You got to make up your mind, come hell or high water, that I'm going to be in this thing today. You got to make up in your mind, for God I live and for God I die. I'm not just passing through, but I'm here to hold on and stay.
Hallelujah.
When you reach the end of your rope, sometimes you got to tie a knot, honey, and hold on to God's unchanging hand. Oh, know that we're going to face some storms of life. Know that trouble will come. It's not if trouble's going to come. It's just when trouble's going to come. Because trouble will come. But as a songwriter said, trouble don't last always.
Amen.
We know that weeping may endure for a night, and joy is coming in the morning, but the problem is I don't know how long your night is going to be.
All right.
I don't know how long the rain clouds are going to be there, but what I do know is that the S-O-N is always shining above the storms of life. There's never come a day that the day doesn't come up. Even when it's dark, the S-U-N is always shining above the storm. And if you and I will learn to look up, for our redemption is drawing nigh. Look up, for help is coming, honey. Oh, he may not come when you want him, but the God that we serve is always on time. God always answers prayers. Yes, no, or wait. And God always changes things. He either changes your situation, or he'll change you to fit in your situation. Oh, he may not always take away your hurt, but he might give you some tranquilizers. He may not always take away your debt, but he might give you a few more dollars in your pocket. Oh, he doesn't always change things, but he lets you know that he's God even in your storm. So you just don't have to come to the church and pass on by. You can't stop, y'all. Oh, you can stop and get what you need, because the God we serve is not only God of the mountaintops, but he's also God in the valleys.
Amen.
He's God when things are going wrong. He's still God. He's God. He was God in the morning, and he'll still be God in the evening. He was God when everything was going well, honey, and he'll still be God if everything falls apart, because he's God. The songwriter said he's God on the platform, he's God at the door, he's God in the amen corner, and he's God all over the floor. And I know God is God, and my God will never change. I know God, he's God, and Jesus is his name.
Amen.
You can call on FEMA if you want to. You can call on Red Cross if you need to. But you'll do better calling on Jesus.
Yes.
Because God still answers prayer.
Yes.
Passing through the church or sitting down and hanging on.
Well.
Passing through the church or holding on to his unchanging hand. Oh, I don't know what you're going through, church, but I do know he can go through it with you.
Yes.
And if God took you to it, my God can bring you through it. And if God says, yes, you can, yes, you can.
Yes.
You might be like Thomas the Train. You might be like that. I think I can. Well, I know I can. Yes, I can. Yes, I can. Why? Because the God that I serve, he's never failed me yet, y'all.
All right.
Oh, I got a few scars now. I got a few kidney surgeries, a pacemaker, defibrillator, heart attack. But you know what? I'm still here.
Amen.
I'm still here.
Amen.
The devil said, well, we're going to take him out. And I thought I was gone, but God said, another day.
Amen.
Amen. We might have beans eat out of a can.
All right.
Well, I got some meat with mine now. album, you still got the beans in the can. I still got some. Excuse me. When you don't have what you need, God said I shall supply all your needs according to my riches in glory. I don't believe in choking, sister. Can you smell that, brother?
Smells good to me.
Get thee behind me. You may not have what you want, but he makes sure you have what you need.
Yes, yes.
And I didn't ask for no food today, but guess what? God brought it to me anyhow. But then after God brought it, guess what I just noticed? There's a plate underneath the shoe. You know, I didn't know that was under there either. I just had to see that and I had to make a sermon about it. And that's what the devil would do. You ain't paying attention. He'll try to steal what you got. So hold on to the Lord, y'all. Hold on, because he'll come and snatch it away. Ah, you forgot our preacher. Out of the abundance of the heart. Amen. But what we want you to know is that you don't have to just pass through.
Amen.
You can hold on. Yes. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. It does not mean the weapon will not be formed. And it does not mean the weapon won't work. It just won't accomplish the end goal. You pull a gun on me, Brother Harold, and you shoot me. But you meant to kill me, but it wounded me.
Wow, wow.
No weapon formed against me. Didn't say the weapon will not be formed. It just said it's not going to work the way it was intended. Amen. The devil tried to kill you. The devil tried to block you. The devil tried to steal your joy. But you know what? You're going to cry. You're going to feel some pain. You might even get mad. You might be angry. You might yell at God, but God's big enough, child. He can handle it. Amen. And when you ask why, he may not answer today, but you will understand it better by and by. And so, because I know I read the back of the book in Revelations, it says we win.
Man.
And because I know we win in the end, I'm going to hang on and see what my change is going to be. Amen. Because I don't know about you, but God's brought me a mighty, 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 mighty long way. God's brought me through some rough places. And I can't give up on God, because God never gave up on me.
Amen.
Oh, if y'all knew me like God knew me, y'all say, he ain't preachers. Oh, but God loved us just as we were. Aren't y'all glad we can't get any better for God to love us more?
Amen.
But aren't you so glad we can't get any worse for God to love us less?
Amen.
God loves you, child, just as you are. Just as you are. With all our shortcomings, all our faults, and all our frailties, God loves you. Stormy's up here from the first church because my battery on my key, it didn't work. And so I had to put my key in my ignition. That slot. First of all, I had to find it. And I ain't never used it. You know, that key you pull out of your knees up. I told the key I was looking for the switch. Well, then I found out you stick that whole thing in there and then my car started. Well, when I shut my door, usually with my key in my pocket, it won't lock because it detects it. Boy, it locked on me. Stormy just got a driver's license. And her mother said, Oh, you get to ride with Stormy. She gonna take you to the church. So I'm in the car with Stormy. It's raining, and she just turned on the windshield wiper and turned it off. I said, why you do that? She said, it gets in my way. I said, oh, Lord. If it's raining fast, but... And then we came, we got up here, Brother Nyree, came by the motorcycle shop, and we turned right, and I said, it's a one-way street. She said, yes, but you're supposed to look both. I'm past that, but that's safe driving.
Man.
Even though I was, can't be going any faster. She go, speed limit 30, she doing 30. Y'all know that's not how we do it. Cause we passing through. Amen, but she brought me here safe and sound and give me a ride back.
Amen.
All I wanna leave us with is that we all gonna face some storms.
Man.
Yeah, yeah.
Don't walk away from the church. When you go through your battle, don't run from the church, run to the church.
Man.
You said, Pastor Green, but this is only a building. True. The true church is right here.
Amen.
But it is a building that's filled with people who are striving to go to the same place.
Amen.
And do the same thing. So when your trouble comes your way, lift your hands high and say, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah, anyhow. Hey, look, I have to worry about being on key. I don't have nothing. Never let your problems get you down. When your problems come your way, lift your hands up high and say,
hallelujah, anyhow.
Oh, you know that? Hallelujah. Bible study. Brother Harold, you're doing a great job. You've been staying awake on me. Brother Harold's been doing a great job on our website, on Facebook, putting everything up. We want to thank Brother Niver and Angela for the cooking they did a couple weeks ago. Yeah, just thank God for the church. We may be small, but we're starting to grow. Things are getting done. We got insurance on our building. We got the building getting fixed. We're going to get painted. We're going to get things together. Let's keep on keeping on, y'all. We haven't got much longer to be here. I want to thank God for our visitors. If they were to introduce themselves, please.
Well, my name is Isaiah Thomas. I'm born in this city. I want to thank y'all for welcoming me to your church.
And we love to have you. Glad to have you. Thank you for coming.
Yeah.
And this is how I am. I try to act professional, but this is how professional I get. So, if you like it, come on back and join us. We're real.
Amen.
We have a problem, but we know what we do. Work it out. No fake, no imitation. It is what it is right now. It is what it is. We want to thank everybody. Sign up, please get with my wife and you know what you're gonna cook so we all don't have beans. Something like that. Or if you like the thing, you know, one guy said, y'all bring the wine. The guy said, well, everybody else gonna bring the wine, so I'm gonna bring a glass of water. So he poured his water in a container and everybody else had water too. So that's everybody sign up. We wanna thank Nyree for the children being here.
Amen.
And never think you can whoop him, son. Until you get some guns like this. Good to have his daughter up, son up, daughter up.
wife up, relatives up.
Yes, amen.
Amen. We just thank you. Young lady, who are you?
Nicola, your neighbor. And Cherie finally got me to come after weeks of...
Amen.
They're from my area, Kansas City, so yeah.
Go Chiefs.
Oh yeah, go Chiefs, yeah.
It's not right here.
Why did I say nothing about the Spurs? Why would I say anything about the Spurs? Or the Cowgirls? Deshaun was it. Ain't gonna say nothing about Deshaun. Just he ain't playing. Oh, Chiefs. Amen. See how you started that and then we invited you. Appreciate everybody. Hope you can come be with us Sunday. You get to taste Nyra's cooking if y'all never ate it before. And everybody else took cooking. And you can't have none of this though. Y'all just listen to Jesus. Y'all shake hands.